We now come to section 3, currency exchange rate calculations. Here we will talk about exchange rate quotations, cross rate calculations, and forward calculations. First, let's look at some exchange rate quotations. Specifically, look at this quote, 1.4000 US dollars to euro. As mentioned before, in this quote, the US dollar is the price currency and the euro is the base currency. I have said this many times before and I will repeat because it is extremely important. Base currency is the currency of which we have just one unit. This means that 1 euro is worth 1.4000 US dollars. US dollars is the price currency. We are talking about the price of 1 euro in terms of US dollars. A direct quote takes the domestic currency as the price currency. An indirect quote takes the domestic currency as the base currency. For a German investor, is the above a direct quote or not? If you are a German investor, then obviously your domestic currency is the euro. The euro, as we have shown over here, is the base currency. Now let's look at the definitions again. A direct quote takes the domestic currency as the price currency. That is not the case over here because the domestic currency is the base currency if you are a German investor. An indirect quote takes the domestic currency as the base currency. That is what is happening over here. So this quote is an indirect quote from the perspective of a German investor. And just to understand the intuition behind this, if you are German, then you think about prices in terms of the euro. If you are buying one dozen bananas, for example, then you will look at the price of bananas in terms of euro. So you will say that one unit of bananas costs 6 euro. Similarly, if you are buying US dollars, then a direct quote will be one where you will say that one US dollar is worth, let's say, 0.8 euro. So from a German perspective, a direct quote will be one where his currency, the euro, is the price currency. This would be a direct quote for an American investor because an American will think in terms of dollars. He wants to know what is the price of a euro in terms of dollars. So make sure you understand this definition. The next point related to currency quotations is the fact that currencies are always quoted as a bid and an ask. And this quote, the bid ask, is from the perspective of the dealer. The bid is the price at which the dealer will buy the base currency from you, and the ask is the price at which the dealer will sell the base currency. And given our convention, the euro is the base currency, that is the one that is coming here in the denominator. So what this is saying is that a dealer will buy 1 euro for $1.3990 and the dealer is also willing to sell 1 euro for $1.4010. The bid price will always be less than the ask, and that is because the dealer makes money based on the bid-ask spread. There will be a lot more on the bid-ask spread at level 2. Here is another point that we've seen before and we are reinforcing over here. When one currency appreciates, the other depreciates. Say the US dollar to euro rate changed from 1.4 to 1.5. Which currency appreciated? As I mentioned before, when this number goes up, that means that the base currency has strengthened. So if your quote is US dollar to euro, where the euro is the base currency, the rate goes up, then the base currency, in this case the euro, has appreciated or increased in value, and the dollar has lost, or the dollar has depreciated. Now, what is the percentage appreciation? To calculate the percentage appreciation for the euro, what you can say is 0.1, which is the change, divided by 1.4 into 100. This will give you the percentage appreciation of the euro. What about the depreciation of the dollar? For that, what you need to do is convert this into a rate for the dollar. The rate for the dollar would be 1 divided by 1.4, which is equal to, when you consider the dollar over here, this is the rate for the dollar. So the dollar was 0.7143 euro, and then the dollar weakened to 0.6667. So we are saying that we went from so many euro to the dollar to 0.6667 euro to $1. Notice that over here the dollar is the base currency. This is the depreciation or a loss in value of 6.67%. When you look at the euro went from 1.4 to 1.5, and this is an appreciation of 7.1%. What I want to emphasize here is that euro going up by 7.1% does not mean that the dollar goes down by 7.1%. The dollar goes down by 6.67%. You can obviously calculate one if you have the other, but these two numbers are not the same. Now let's take a look at example four from the curriculum. A dealer based in New York City provides a spot exchange rate quote of this, and notice that we are told that this is the convention, MXN over USD. So USD is the base currency, Mexican peso is the price currency. And for convenience, we are also given the inverse. What this means is that 0.0806 would be USD over MXN. From the perspective of the Mexican client, what is the direct exchange rate? Now remember, a Mexican client wants his currency as the price currency, and that is the case over here. 12.4035 is the price currency, which is the Mexican peso. The Mexican wants to know how much he can buy or sell $1 for, and $1 is for 12.4035 Mexican peso. So that is the direct exchange rate for the Mexican. Let's do question two now. If the bid offer quote from the dealer was 12.4020 and 12.4060 Mexican to USD, what is the bid offer quote in terms of USD over Mexican peso? Here the USD is the base currency, so I have indicated that over here. The dealer is willing to buy the base currency, which is the USD, for 12.4020 Mexican peso, and the dealer is willing to sell $1 for this much. To come up with the quote in terms of USD over Mexican peso, which means the Mexican peso is the base currency, we need to take the reciprocal. Remember, if the dealer is willing to buy dollars, that is the same thing as the dealer selling peso. This is the ask or the sell side. And for that, we need to take the reciprocal. The reciprocal of 12.4020 is 0.08063. This is the ask. 12.4 is how much the dealer is asking for $1. In other words, he is selling a dollar for 12.406. Selling dollars is the same thing as buying peso. This is the bid or the buy side. We take the reciprocal of 12.4060 and come up with 0.08061. So this is our bid ask spread with the Mexican peso as the base currency. Section 3.2, cross rate calculations. Given two exchange rates and three currencies, it is possible to determine the third exchange rate. And this third exchange rate which you calculate is called the cross rate. Let's take a very simple example. We have two exchange rates here and three currencies. Given these two exchange rates, you want to find the PKR, Indian rupee exchange rate. So how do we do that? It's basic algebra, PKR over the Indian rupee. Here, the Indian rupee is the base currency. This is given by PKR over USD multiplied by USD over INR. Notice that if we can use these two rates, the dollar cancels out and the product of these two exchange rates will be the PKR INR rate. The PKR USD is given, that is 100, multiplied by USD INR. Over here, the INR is the base currency, but in the quote given, the USD is the base currency. So what we actually do here is multiply by the reciprocal of this. The reciprocal of this is USD over INR, and that would be 1 over 60. So rather than multiplying by 60, we multiply by 1 over 60. So our exchange rate is 100 over 60, which is 1.6667. This is the cross rate. And the interpretation is that one Indian rupee is worth this many Pakistani rupees. Now let's consider example 5 from the curriculum, where we will do some cross exchange rate calculations and look at percentage changes in currency. Here is the information given related to the US dollar, euro, Swiss franc, and the British pound. What is the Swiss franc euro cross rate? And I want you to do these before you look at the solutions. Here is what you need to do. This is exactly like what we saw on the previous example. The answer is 1.3381. This many Swiss francs for 1 euro. What is the spot GBP euro cross rate? Here we need to find the GBP to euro exchange rate, and this is equal to GBP over USD times USD over euro. Again, notice that the USD will cancel out. GBP over USD. Here USD is the base currency, but in the information given, the GBP is the base currency. So we take the reciprocal of this number, which is shown right here, multiplied by USD to euro, and that is given right here. Do the multiplication or the division, and you have 0.8808 GBP for 1 euro. Next question, is the euro expected to appreciate or depreciate against the USD? We've done this before, so this is a quick revision. Look at what's happening to the USD to euro. Euro is the base currency, and this is the spot rate. The expected spot rate after 1 year is 1.38. Notice that this expected spot rate is coming down, which means that the base currency, i.e. the euro, is expected to weaken. By how much? For that, you simply take the difference between these two and then divide by the original spot rate, and that should give you minus 0.7%. Which currency is expected to be the strongest over the next year? This is an important point. The strongest currency is the one which appreciates the most, or in this scenario, the currency which is expected to appreciate the most. So let us do a very basic exercise here before we solve any numbers. Between the USD and the euro, clearly the USD is expected to be stronger than the euro. So if we are to just on a vertical axis depict the various currencies where higher means stronger, what about between the USD and the Swiss franc? Between the USD and the Swiss franc, this number is 0.958 and 0.955. So here we are saying that the base currency is becoming weaker. So the US dollar is becoming weaker relative to the Swiss franc. That means that the Swiss franc is over here. What about the US dollar relative to the pound? 1.585, and here we have 1.57. This means that the pound is expected to weaken against the dollar. So we have GBP over here. We could compare these two if we were to find the weakest currency, but given the information here, clearly the Swiss franc is expected to be the strongest currency over the upcoming year. I have skipped a few MCQ questions from this example, which I definitely want you to do. So make sure you go through the curriculum and do all the MCQs from example 5. Next, we come to section 3.3, forward calculations. Forward exchange rates are generally quoted in terms of points or pips. We've already talked about the concept of a forward rate, and I will refresh that concept very briefly. A spot rate is the rate that is in effect now. In our example here, which is based on the USD euro exchange rates, the spot rate is 1.2875. The forward rate is the rate that we lock in today for a transaction in the future. And these numbers over here give us various forward rates. This indicates the forward rate for a 1 week forward transaction. This number over here indicates what the forward rate should be for a 12-month or 1 year transaction. In other words, we are locking in a rate today for a transaction that will take place after 12 months. Now let's understand what minus 26.5 means. The minus is straightforward. All this is saying is that the forward rate is less than the spot rate. So we can look at that minus sign and immediately say that the base currency, in this case the euro, is weakening. Or we also say that the euro is the weaker currency over here. Now, how do we connect 26.5 to this number, the spot rate? When we have two currencies, such as the US dollar to euro, where the quoting convention is to use four decimal places, then we convert this number, which is in points or pips, into a decimal by dividing this number by 10,000. The way you remember this, and this is a convention, if you have four decimal places in our quoting convention, then to convert points into a decimal, you take the points number or the pips number and divide by 10,000. 10,000 has four zeros. So this four and the four zeros is the same number. What do we get when we divide 26.5 by 10,000? This is your basic class 6 maths. You move the decimal place back four places, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the number in decimals. Since we have a minus here, we also put a minus. Now we subtract this number from 1.2875. So we have 1.2875 minus 0.00265, and this gives us this number. Notice that the forward rate is lower than the spot rate by this amount. At times, forward points are expressed as a percentage of the spot rate, and you see that calculation over here. The forward points 26.5 can be converted into this decimal. The decimal as a percentage of 1.2875 is minus 0.21% approximately. In the example that I just showed you, we converted points to decimal by dividing by 10,000. For some currencies, such as the Japanese yen, or I should say for some exchange rates, such as Japanese yen to USD, the convention is to use two decimal places. When we have a two decimal place convention, then converting points to decimal requires a division by 100. So let's do this simple example. We have the spot exchange rate, which is 100.55, and the 6 month forward rate, which is 100.40. The difference between these two numbers in decimal is equal to 0.15, and this is actually a negative. The forward rate is lower in this example. That is the decimal number. So what is the number of forward points or pips? The points here would mean that we multiply by 100. When we multiply by 100, we will have minus 15. So notice that if we were given the points, then to convert to decimal, we would divide by 100 and get to this number, and we would then subtract this number from the spot rate in order to come up with the forward rate. In the questions that you might get on the exam, either you will be dividing by 10,000 to come up with the decimal number, or you will be dividing by 100 depending on the exchange rate which is given. We will now talk about the link between spot rates, forward rates, and interest rates. And that link is given by this formula, which is extremely important and one that you must memorize. I will write this down and then we will use some very simple numbers to compute the forward rate. The forward rate, which is expressed as a price currency over base currency, is equal to the spot rate, again expressed as price over base, multiplied by 1 plus the interest rate in the price currency, divided by 1 plus the interest rate in the base currency. Notice that the base currency interest rate is in the base, in this formula, base being the denominator. Now let us apply a few numbers here. Say the spot rate of the rupee to dollar, and notice that the dollar here is the base currency. That spot rate, let's say, is 100. And then the interest rate for the price currency, which is the rupee, is 10%. And we are talking about 1 year interest rates. And let's say that this is a 1 year forward contract, just to keep things simple. We multiply by 1 plus the rupee interest rate, which is 10% or 0.1. And then we divide by 1 plus the base currency interest rate, which is 1%. In the denominator, we then have 1 plus 0.01. When we do the calculation, we get 108.91. So this is the forward rate, which we compute based on the spot rate and the interest rates in the two different currencies. Again, I emphasize that this is an extremely important formula to remember. Now, a few important points related to this formula. The currency with the higher interest rate will always trade at a discount in the forward market. In the example that we just talked about, we had a given spot rate. The base currency here was the dollar. Remember, this was 100 rupees to the dollar. So the base currency was the dollar and the price currency was the rupee. And we said that the interest rate for the price currency or the rupee was 10% and the interest rate for the base currency, i.e. the dollar, was 1%. The rupee has the higher interest rate. This means that the rupee will trade at a discount. Trading at a discount means that in terms of the forward rate, the rupee is weakening. The forward rate that we just calculated was 108.9. So the rate is going from 100 to 108.91. The base currency, the dollar, is clearly strengthening, and we've done this enough times. When the spot rate goes up, that means that the base is strengthening, which means that the rupee is weakening. If this number, the forward rate, shows that a given currency is weakening, then we say that that currency is trading at a discount. So here the rupee is trading at a discount. What about the currency with the lower interest rate? The currency with the lower interest rate is clearly the dollar, and this will trade at a premium in the forward market, and that is what we see over here. The dollar is trading at a premium. The dollar's forward rate is higher than the spot rate. This relationship helps ensure that there is no arbitrage. And to understand this, let us do a very simple example. For a moment, let us assume that the spot rate is 100 and the forward rate is 100. If these were indeed the interest rates, where on the rupee we can get 10% and the dollar is only paying 1%, then what an arbitrager could do is take a dollar, convert it into 100 rupees, get 10% on the rupee, and then convert back into dollars. And clearly, when he converts back into dollars, he will get more than what he would get simply by investing dollars at 1%. And he would do so without taking any risk. If someone can get a return of more than 1% on the dollar without taking risk, that is arbitrage. The only exchange rate that prevents any sort of arbitrage in this context is this particular rate of 108.91, which is calculated based on the interest rates in both currencies. Next point, which is a subtle point and one that we will see in examples later. If the forward contract is for X days, let's say 90 days, then we make an adjustment based on 90 over 360. So what do I mean by that? If we are talking about a 90-day forward contract using the same interest rates, then the forward rate of the rupee to dollar would be equal to the spot rate, which is 100, into 1 plus the interest rate in the price currency, which we've said is 0.1. This would then be multiplied by 90 over 360. And in the denominator, we'll have 1 plus 0.01. and this would also be multiplied by 90 over 360. We are using 90 over 360 to de-annualize these interest rates. Now let's work through example 6 in the curriculum. And I want you to try this first before looking at the solution. Here is how you think about this. We are taking a French perspective. The relevant currency is the euro. If the French company is going to receive 50 million pounds at some point in the future, the risk is that the pound will be weaker relative to the euro when the money is received. To mitigate that risk, what the French company can do is sell pounds in the forward market. And remember from earlier discussions that selling pounds is exactly the same as buying euro. So if you look at the solutions, or if you look at the options, the correct answer would be B. We would buy euro in the forward market, and the relevant rate is 0.87506. So the correct answer is B. We come up with this number by using the spot rate and adjusting based on the forward points. For the second question, the two possible answers are A and C. But remember, in questions like this, when we are using the forward rate formula that I just showed you, the best interpretation is this one, where we can say for sure that if interest rates are higher in a given region, here it's the Eurozone, then that currency will have a lower forward rate relative to the spot rate. In other words, here we can see that the euro is down. In other words, the forward rate is less than the spot rate for the euro being the base currency. If this is true, then we must have a situation where the Eurozone has higher rates. This comes with practice. Once you've done a question like this, you will be able to do this right on the exam. Next, we need to do a basic calculation. If the 12-month forward rate is this, then based on the data given, the 12-month forward points are closest to what? Here is what you do. Simply take the difference between the forward rate and the spot rate. That gives you a decimal number. And remember, with pound euro, we multiply by 10,000 to come up with the points. The answer is minus 22.5. Next question. If a second dealer is quoting the euro at a 0.3% discount, then what can the French company do to make some money? The first thing you do is calculate what the forward rate would be. And applying the 0.3% discount, you notice that the second dealer is offering a forward rate of this much. Compare this with what the first dealer is offering. Once you've made the comparison, you apply rule number one of finance, which is that you buy low and sell high. In this particular case, you will buy in the forward market from the dealer who is selling low, and you will sell to the dealer who will buy at a high price. So who do you buy from in the forward market? Clearly, this number is lower. So you will buy from dealer 2 or the second dealer. So you will lock in the 12-month euro rate. You will buy the base currency, the euro, from the second dealer in the forward market. And you will sell to the original dealer because he is giving you a higher price for the euro. Correct answer is B. And finally, you need to do this calculation. Here is what you do. Note that the euro is the base currency. Therefore, the interest rate for the euro, which is this number over here, shows up in the denominator, and the interest rate of the price currency, which is the pound, shows up here in the numerator. We make the adjustment for 270 days and we come up with this forward rate. Since the euro interest rate is higher, the forward rate is lower than the spot rate. The euro is trading at a discount relative to the pound. The question asks for the number of forward points. So we will do the forward rate minus the spot rate and multiply by 10,000, and that will give you